Thank you. Hey, hey.
What?
That guy over there. He's still alive.
Huh? What about the others? You alone?
What's your name? Your unit?
Second Lieutenant Kai Marganar, Commander, 17th Platoon, Armored Magic Troopers.
It's a miracle you made it. Come with me. This way. Unbelievable. One survivor.
Yeah. Amazing he made it out safe. Especially in that up.
That's Officer Seth Balmore with the 43rd Magic Division. She's like you. She got out in one piece.
Really? You two are walking miracles.
Hey, I...
Here's where you get off, Lieutenant.
The Council wishes to hear from a survivor, sir. Sorry, not you, Officer Balmore.
Hey, I'm a survivor, too.
The Council has only summoned Lieutenant Arganar. Sit down and shut up.
Well, that's just weird.
This way, Lieutenant.
Follow me.
that guy, right? The soldier that can't die. The 17th Division. That was the front line. They were smack in the middle of the Wohl Highlands. No one could have survived that meteor crash. But here you are, without a scratch.
Beg your pardon, Lieutenant. That's really strange. The few we were able to save were far from the center of impact. And even those men were seriously injured. It's just... it's hard to believe that anyone could have survived that inferno.
Then don't believe it.
The Council won't like that attitude. Come on, tell us. How'd you make it?
Ago, a new power manifested itself onto the world. With its discovery came the Magic Industrial Revolution. This power came to be called magic energy. Even now, there are none who can explain why this power, a power that merely lay buried within all living creatures, suddenly flourished as it did. Today, this magic energy permeates every corner of the world. It has changed the way people live, transformed the shape of industry, and has even altered the nature of war.
Is it true the Kents have requested a truce?
Indeed. We heard that enough men were committed to cover the Wohl Highlands, and that most of the Kent force were eliminated. This war was started by them. It's only right they withdraw.
We've also lost a tremendous number of troops. After suffering such a devastating loss, if the Gotsa were to strike now, there would be no way we could defend our country.
And there are also whispers that Gotsa was pulling strings behind the invasion.
What makes you think that the Gotsa were involved?
We have confirmed that a large amount of military hardware has been moved from Gotsa to Kent. We assume Goetze plans to use Kent to keep things stirred up and destabilize Ura.
Are you saying that even the meteor crash was a Goetzean plot?
My lord, I have some disturbing information on that subject. We suspect that a situation at Grand Staff may have caused the meteor crash.
Grand Staff? This is not the first time that stories about it have reached my ears.
This is not confirmed, but magic energy may have leaked out of Grand Staff, interfered with something in outer space, and precipitated this disaster.
Gongora!
Yes, my lord.
The Grand Staff falls under your jurisdiction. Do you have anything to say?
Nothing for the moment. Where did you get this information? Construction of Grand Staff is going smoothly.
Now that the forces of Ura have suffered such devastating losses, I think we have no other way to protect our land except with the magic energy that Grand Staff will provide. We should hold off on debating the pros and cons of Grand Staff until we thoroughly review the world's current situation.
What you say makes sense, but our plan to use magic energy is a double-edged sword. With all sorts of rumors flying around, we might want to halt construction of Grand Staff.
What?
Only temporarily. As soon as it's clear that Grand Staff had nothing to do with the meteor collision, we'll resume construction immediately, Gongora.
Thanks to this new device, they say that we could see a much more...